project in the wood shop today is to make an auxiliary fence for my SawStop JobSite Pro. I'm Ron Paul, and this is the Smart Wood Shop. If you want to get a detailed set of plans to build a smart wood shop for yourself or one of the smart workbenches, there's a link in the description of this video down below. That's right, right down there. You can click on that link and go and purchase plans and download them instantaneously, 24/7, 365. Adding an auxiliary fence to the SawStop or any table saw has a lot of advantages. Making it out of wood, first and foremost for me, allows me to move the fence very close to the blade. In fact, I can even have the blade cut into the fence slightly, which is really helpful when I'm trying to do small rabbits with the blade, or if I'm using a dado blade and I want to do a rabbit with the dado blade, but I want to adjust the size, I can actually cut up into the fence a little bit, which you can't do with the stock fence. Also, I can add on feather boards and attachments and stop blocks. So let's get started on building this. I wanted it to just drop over so that I could quickly remove it. So this one, the first mistake I made was I made it too tight. So even with these knobs completely undone, it pinches on the fence. I've decided I want to make it taller, so I'm going to start with 7 inches. I dug through my lumber pile and I found some 18 millimeter ply, which would be perfect. This first piece here, I've already cut to length and width. So it is 7 inches wide and 36 inches long. I'm gonna go for a nice round number and make the center of the T-track about 85 millimeters up from the bottom. For the dado on the backside, that's where the bridge piece is gonna float over the top of the fence. That doesn't need to be really tight. I actually want a little air space between the top of the fence and the bottom of the bridge, just so that I know that the fence will sit all the way down on the table saw. 70 millimeters, and that is going to be the bottom edge of my dado. With those details figured out, now I can go over to the router table. With the face of the auxiliary fence complete and detailed out, I can figure out the bridge piece. That little bit of extra that I have play front to back, that's on purpose so that I can drop it in. If I would have made it so that it was tight front to back, then it would be difficult to get it down. I'd be struggling with that. So this allows me just enough room to drop it in and push it forward. There's no side-to-side play. I made it just tight enough that it'll drop on without having to force it. This is a steret combination square. This is about as square as this kind of instrument gets, and it's just absolutely perfect. The T-tracks should work out great. I like to use them on the table saw. Like when I want to put a block back in here for doing cross cutting, you know, a lot of times, you know, when you, especially you're doing narrow stuff, you don't want to have it actually touching the fence to do your cross cut. So if you set up a block and then you set your actual length that you need with your cross cut miter gauge, then you can bump the block with it behind the blade here and then push it through and slide it over, bump it, push it through. And by doing that, there's no potential for the material to come in and turn and get kicked by the blade. I put a little 1/8 by 1/8 dust channel on the bottom, just so that, you know, you get a little dust here. It gives it a place for the dust to go and not force your material out and you not notice it. I can use this T-track for these infeed and outfeed rollers, or I can use them for feather boards as well. By leaving this backside up a bit, I think it helps with the stiffening. I've got a deeper dado about halfway through the material, and that's glued and screwed. And then, of course, it's glued and screwed to the other side. So that creates a really nice I-beam. It should keep it fairly flat. And then the blocks front and back, which act as stops, also help keep it squared up. Main reason for this extra height is when I'm running a, you know, a narrow piece of stock, I want to do a lap joint or a rabbit on the narrow end, then I can stand it up and then use a push block to hold it there and push it through. So I'll keep my hands completely out of the way and I won't be worried about it tipping. On the saw stop, I had to account for the lock. The lock here is integral on the top of the fence, and I did not want to have to take this off every time I wanted to make an adjustment. So I'll be able to drop it on and then I can unlock it, move it where I need it, and I can still clearly see the scale, so it'll be easy to set up and lock it in. The scale, of course, will be off by the thickness of this fence, but that would be true with any auxiliary fence you put on any table saw. I showed you how I walked through this to figure out how to do it on the saw stop, which has its special needs, like this lock on the top. It doesn't matter what table saw you have or what fence your table saw has. You can work out something like this to fit your saw by walking through the same procedure I did. Just take your time, step through it, start with building the face of your fence, that's the most important part, and then working on the other parts that will help it to fit on your fence and in a manner that you can drop it on and easily remove it. If you like this video, be sure to, right down below, hit that thumbs up. And if you really didn't like the video, hit that thumbs down twice. Also, if you get a chance, subscribe so you won't miss any of the videos that I put up. But most important, I would really appreciate it if you would share this channel with somebody you know. Thanks for dropping into the Smart Wood Shop. You stay safe and have a great day.